Part 1, The Illusion of a Smooth Universe. If you could take a deep breath in the heart of our galaxy, deep inside the Sagittarius B2 cloud, you'd smell rum and taste raspberries. It's a result of ethyl formate. It's a fun fact, but it's a distraction. Just a cover for a reality that is far more chaotic and deeply broken than we ever thought possible. In this video, I'm going to show you the evidence, the structures, the stars, and the voids that, according to our current rulebook, simply shouldn't exist. For decades, we've relied on the cosmological principle. It's the golden rule of physics. It states that on a large enough scale, the universe is homogeneous and isotropic. Think of the universe like a high-resolution image. Up close, you see the pixels, galaxies, and clusters. But from a distance, the picture should be a smooth, gray blur. No structure should be larger than about 1.2 billion light years. This is the scale of homogeneity. The problem is, we are starting to see jagged lines and shapes where the blur should be. Part 2, structures that violate the rules. First, look at the giant arc and the big ring. Together, they span billions of light years. The odds of these structures existing by chance are roughly 1 in 3.5 million. Then there is the Kipu. Discovered in high-energy X-ray data from the Erosita telescope, this structure spans 2.8 billion light-years. It's a knotted cord of galaxies containing 200 quadrillion solar masses, blowing past what our models predict. But the most controversial is the Hercules-Corona Borealis Great Wall. Spanning 10 billion light-years, it is so large that many astronomers dismiss it as a statistical ghost in our data. If it is real, it messes with our basic ideas about how smooth the early universe was. Makes you wonder how something that huge showed up in only 13.8 billion years. These might be cosmic strings cracks in the structure of space itself. Or perhaps Hawking points. Faint traces left over from a universe that existed before our Big Bang. Part 3. The Great Voids and the Dipole Repeller. If these walls are too much matter, the next weird thing is the horror of not enough. The KBC Void is a huge empty pocket spanning 2 billion light years, and we are sitting right in the middle of it. Some astrophysicists argue this local void could be the missing link in the Hubble tension. This is a local anomaly that makes the expansion of the distant universe look like it's running at the wrong speed. And if being alone wasn't enough, we're being abandoned. The Dipole Repeller acts like a gravitational vacuum. We aren't being pushed, we are being left behind. Because the space behind us is empty, the gravity of the rest of the universe is pulling us away, and there's nothing on the other side to pull us back. Combined with the pull of the Great Attractor, our entire galaxy is drifting through the dark at 630 kilometers per second toward a destination we can't see. Speaking of invisible forces, there is one that really powers this channel, the hype button. If you are enjoying this trip through the cosmos, please give it a click. It honestly helps more than you know. Part 4, the cold spot and the axis of evil. If the universe is supposed to be this big, messy blur, the cosmic microwave background, CMB, the leftover heat from the Big Bang, should look the same no matter where you look. But it doesn't. Way down in the southern sky, there's this thing called the CMB cold spot. It's a giant patch that is way colder than everything around it. It shouldn't be there. Everything we've learned about the early universe says the temperature should fluctuate a bit. Sure, but not like this. Some scientists think it's a super void, basically a place so empty it sucks the energy out of light passing through it. But others have a much weirder theory. The cold spot could be a bruise. It might be the literal spot where our universe bumped into another one while it was expanding. It's a glitch that makes it look like we're just one bubble in a much bigger sink. Then there is the axis of evil. When scientists looked at the heat map of the universe, they found a strange arrangement. The biggest ripples in the CMB seem to line up perfectly with our own solar system. This is a huge problem. The universe shouldn't care where Earth is. It's like finding out the grain in your floorboards points right at your bed. It means either our math is broken, or that smooth universe we've been talking about doesn't actually exist. and we're at the center of a bizarre setup we can't explain. Part 5. Zombie stars and strange matter. Individual stars are behaving like villains in a horror movie. IPTF-14HLS, the zombie star, has exploded multiple times over 72 years, breaking every rule of how stars die. Then there is the runaway black hole, barreling through space at over 1,600 kilometers per second. That is fast enough to cross the Atlantic in 3 seconds. In 2023, astronomers spotted what appeared to be its 200,000 light-year-long trail of stars, though the discovery remains a huge argument. But the most terrifying is strange matter. If certain neutron stars are actually strange stars made of quark matter, they are stable until they aren't. If such a star sheds even a single tiny speck known as a strangelet, it becomes a cosmic infection. It would force a chain reaction, causing every atom it touches to collapse into the perfect state of strange matter. If a strangelet hit Earth, the conversion would release so much energy that the planet would incinerate itself from the inside out, turning into a white-hot sphere of strange matter in a process that ignores every safety rule in the book. If that didn't give you an existential crisis, maybe drop a like and subscribe. We've got plenty more nightmares to cover. Part 6. Dark flow and the invisible pull. We like to think the universe expands evenly, like a balloon blowing up. But something is pulling us. Astronomers stumbled onto this weird thing called dark flow. It's a huge stream of galaxy clusters. Thousands of them are all moving in the exact same direction at over 2 million miles per hour. They aren't just moving with the expansion, they're being dragged toward a certain patch of sky between the constellations of Centaurus and Hydra. The glitch is, there's nothing visible over there big enough to cause this. Whatever is pulling those galaxies is way past the edge of what we can see. It's just there. We can't see it or measure it. And to be honest, we have no clue why. It's like the whole universe is just draining out into an invisible hole. Part 7. Nuclear pasta and hybrid stars. Inside a neutron star, gravity crushes nuclei into nuclear pasta, which is 10 billion times stronger than steel. These sheets create mountains on the star's surface. Even though they are only millimeters high, those tiny bumps weigh more than Mount Everest. As the star spins, these Everest lumps tear up space-time, sending out invisible ripples that detectors can pick up across the cosmos. Even weirder are Thorne-Jitkov objects. This is a red supergiant that has swallowed a neutron star. The dead star sits at the center like a zombie brain. It acts as a nuclear engine that forces the host star to bleed elements that shouldn't exist in a living star, like rubidium and molybdenum. It's basically a chemical Frankenstein. Part 8. Ghost galaxies and Hoag's object. We've also found glitches in how galaxies are put together. Take AGC 114905. It's a galaxy the size of the Milky Way, but it seems to have absolutely no dark matter. Based on everything we know, you shouldn't be able to have a galaxy without dark matter acting as what holds the whole thing together. Finding a galaxy without it is like finding a skyscraper standing with no frame. Then there is Hoag's object. It looks like a yellow core surrounded by a loose ring of bright blue stars. It looks like a target. For years, we thought it was just a collision between two galaxies, but the numbers just don't add up. The ring is too perfect, and the center is too old. And here's the real glitch. If you look through the gap between the ring and the center, you can see another ring galaxy way further away that looks exactly like it. It's such a freak coincidence that it really looks like a copy-paste error in the simulation. Part 9. Magnetars and the Amaterasu particle. In 2004, the Magnetar SGR180620 released more energy in 1/5 of a second than our sun has produced in 150,000 years. The blast was so powerful, it totally blinded every X-ray satellite in orbit from 50,000 light-years away. Then there's the Amaterasu particle. It's a single subatomic particle that hit our atmosphere with the kinetic energy of a brick dropped on your toe. Tracing it back leads to the local void. This region doesn't just lack galaxies. It lacks the magnetic machinery to accelerate a particle to these energies. It's not just a bullet from an empty room. It is a bullet from a room that doesn't even contain a gun. Part 10, Vacuum Decay. The ultimate glitch of all is vacuum decay. Think of it as a forced cosmic software update. Right now, the universe is running on physics 1.0. But our vacuum state might only be a false vacuum, which is essentially a temporary ledge. If the Higgs field drops to its true vacuum state at even a single point, it will create a bubble expanding at the speed of light. Inside, the laws of physics are rewritten. The new code doesn't just crash your system. It deletes the hardware. Atoms cease to exist. Because the bubble moves at the speed of light, you will never see it coming. 1 second you exist, the next, the server is wiped. The map is broken, the stars are zombies, and the void is shooting at us. We are lucky to be here for this short pause before the whole thing falls apart. So, be honest. Do you think these glitches are just physics we don't understand? Or is this proof that we're living in a simulation that's running out of RAM? Drop your theories in the comments. Sleep well.